a lot of knowledge coming your way as well with our next guest, Tori Dott of Women's Soccer Assistant Coach. Tori, thanks for coming on the show.
Thanks for having me.
Appreciate you taking some time out of your schedule. I know things are getting busy, gearing up for the last game of the season, ODAC tournament coming up. With the team this year, we've seen ups and downs, even some downs that we're not used to, of course, which is territory that we talk about the players not being used to, but even as coaches, you guys haven't experienced losing at home or especially in the ODAC at all in a while. In that moment, from a coaching standpoint, how do you make sure that that doesn't kill your season?
I think with that, that's a pivotal moment because you can go two ways. You can give up and complain and you haven't been there for a while, so it's easy to throw your arms up, or you can see what you need to work on and address it and then attack that. So I think we've been really good about going back to the books and thinking like, okay, where have we missed? Where do we need to get better? And let's go with that way.
Has that been actually a point in the year that has helped you guys with your success as of late?
I think it's crazy though this year is that every game we're seeing a different challenge. So usually we focus on one thing all season, whether it's outside mid play, center mid play, the defense. This year it's like, all right, this week we're focused on center mids. Next week we're outside mids. And honestly, every game we know what we need to do to attack the next player. So a couple people sit in, so we're working on forwards. A couple people are coming out and pressuring our center mid, so we need to work on them under pressure. So it's just every week is an interesting practice, which I really like.
Keeps it on your toes.
Yeah, definitely.
Last thing about the team currently, we know that we're not going to host the tournament, but do you try and take it from a coaching angle and say, hey, that's fine, we'll win it on somebody else's turf?
That's just another challenge. Our girls do a lot of off-the-field work in the fall, in the spring, and that's just one more thing you can throw at them. Like, how many things have you done? Now you can go steal it from this team who thinks they have it set. Mm-hmm. So for us, we're more about a dream crushing. So interesting to go to somewhere where they think they have it in the bag and then hopefully take
right.
it from them.
I like that. I like that a lot. Well, we wish you the best of luck next week
when
it does take place, and good luck on Saturday
Thanks.
As well. Speaking of dreams, you have some dreams. You don't necessarily want to be here
Pretty
forever.
Big ones.
But you like to teach. You want to be around mm-hmm. younger kids. Third and fourth grade seems to be your area, which you really enjoy. What about that age piques your interest?
I think they're still really curious, and I heard a statistic way long back is that a third grader or a fourth grader, that's the age where they decide that they're bad at something, and I want to kind of intervene there and let them know they're still good at it. I don't want them to make that decision that they're going to decide they're bad at math for the rest of their life, or they're bad at reading for the rest of their life. So if I can get in that age and turn it around, I think it's really meaningful.
That's a great point. That's a really admirable reason to get into something.
We'll see if it's true.
Well, right. You'll find out. Right? Whenever that does happen, you would certainly be able to find out. With that comes, needing to be around students, younger kids. Obviously, you have the coaching side of it, but you and really this program does a lot of work for sports outreach and taking trips to Africa and helping out others that really need external help. What about those trips do you still, because you're going back for what, third time? Why continue to go back? What about them, those trips, get you excited and passionate to keep going?
I've been very blessed that coach kind of, from the time I got here, was really putting it in my brain about let's go to Africa, see what you can do. And then once you're there, it's just they want to be educated so bad. There's students that will sit, three-year-olds that will sit quietly for 3 hours waiting for their turn to have an hour of class. So for me to watch that, just these students really want to learn, just bring it back here in the States where people are like, oh, they don't want to go to school, trying to come, I'm sick, things like that. So if I could just bring a little bit of that from Africa to the United States, I think our education system will be more interesting and way better. So
I do agree with that. I do agree with that. I think we do take a lot of things for granted as well.
Me too. I had my fair day of sickness.
So right. For sure. I'm actually looking forward to y'all's next trip. I was asked to go, so that'll be...
You should. I'll sit next to you on the plane.
Okay.
Or you can sit in front of me and I'll just nail you.
Let's not do that. But I'll sit next to you for sure.
Awesome.
I'll probably get that anyway, depending on who's sitting behind us. Speaking of you doing something like that, you say you're not known, maybe as this, but anybody that's around you could probably figure out that you were a class clown in high school.
I was.
And to go along with the clown thing, you actually could ride a unicycle?
Yeah, for my birthday when I was 11, actually it might have been Christmas, they're around the same time, I got a red unicycle and it came with a red pole, so it helped you practice, and I would just go up and down the street with my pole and my unicycle, and finally my dad was like, I'm too embarrassed to see you with the pole, you gotta get rid of it. So then I learned to do it.
So it wasn't the unicycle, it was the pole with the unicycle.
Yeah, he was more embarrassed about the pole, which my mom was probably embarrassed about it all, so it doesn't really matter.
Okay. So can you still ride a unicycle?
I haven't been on one in a couple years, but I mean, I'm willing to give it a try.
Okay. Well, we might have to talk to the right people
and
make that happen, because that would be a viral video.
Coach Waters,
that would take.
If you're listening, really would like an Adidas unicycle.
Specifically Adidas. We'll talk to Rob, see if he can hook us up with that.
Awesome.
As well. Also, outside of the coaching world, you did play here.
Mm-hmm.
And we talk about the school in general, the feel, the athletics at this school is second to none. Why would you still harp on that message? You know, now that you've been separated from the athletic side of it, now you're a coach, does that message still hold up no matter what level you're at this school?
I mean, the reason I came back was just to give back. I felt that my 4 years here were incredible, amazing. I wouldn't change a single thing, and just the only way I could repay that would to give it back to the new players coming in. So, I mean, another 3 years of my life hanging out in Virginia just so I can give back what I've gotten, and it's been so huge.
That right there is just a spotlight story just about anybody I talk to has a similar story of why they want to continue to be involved. So no surprises there. We do have a surprise for our viewers. You know about this. We're going to play a game. We have to. Tori Dodd is here. Tori Dodd loves games.
As do
the crew. If they don't, we're going to have to deal with it anyway. So here are my questions, and I have your questions. So it's time to play Rapid Fire.
You first, I'm first, who's first?
I'll go first.
You're asking me.
I'm asking you first. All right? A lot of pressure.
Got it.
Okay? So, you ready?
I'm ready.
Official timer, are you ready? Okay?
I'm ready. You start when you want.
All right. And we're going to start right now. Number one, if you could have any superpower, what would it be and why?
Invisibility, because Harry Potter was invisible once.
If you performed a comedy show, who would be your stand-up partner?
Chelsea Lately.
Oh, okay.
Chelsea
Handler. Good choice. Name a person from history you'd like to meet.
George Washington, just because I can't think of anything else.
And last thing is, use one word to describe Joe Hutzler.
Joe Hutzler, corny!
Corny? 5 seconds to spare, wow.
Go back to history. Oh, I'm done.
We're sticking with George Washington.
I'm thinking someone. That's
first president.
Hard one.
That's a good, from Virginia,
someone.
So yeah. Corny.
Corny.
Really?
Like these games are corny, but really fun. Corny, but fun.
Okay, nice save.
Fun, but corny,
Nice
fun,
save, okay.
People All right. first language.
All right, now it's your turn to not be corny.
Were you looking?
No, of course not. Maybe I was looking, but I couldn't read.
All right, let me know when.
When you're ready.
We're ready? What sport do you wish you would have played?
Ice hockey.
What's your favorite social media outlet?
Instagram.
Instagram. If you went to the greatest classic rock concert of all time, what three bands would be featured?
Lynyrd Skynyrd, REO Speedwagon, and Guns N' Roses.
Nice. What's your dream car?
A 1969 Mustang GT500.
Wow, very specific.
Silver with black stripes. Oh, I got in there too.
That was
awesome.
Quick.
Any more questions? No. Okay.
Didn't get
one more extra one in there. All right. Well, that was awesome. Now everybody knows a lot more about us and a lot more about my love for old things, classic rock and classic cars. Thank you for doing that, by the way.
I'll take
that from you. And before we go, I do want to bring up, what this season, when you look at the end, I know it's hard to think about it because it's not over yet and you want to still be playing 2-3 weeks from now. But if you can take the regular season to this point and describe this team, is there something, is it one word, is it a sentence that really puts a stamp on what this team has done?
I mean, if there's anything, is that we have to go out there and play like we have a target on our back every game, because this year they finally nailed it. So everyone's coming out and they're playing 100% against us, so target on our back, and it's just seeing how we can pull together as a team and remove it and attack for them. So
well, I'm super excited about your chances for sure.
I hope so.
Going right in with a lot peaking and a nice streak going, so it's going to be really interesting. We hope that you guys follow it as well. You can, of course, do that by going to lynchburgsports.com. Thanks for watching the show today. Tori, thanks for coming on the show.
Thank you for having me.
It was great. We're going to have you back for sure. This was very, very fun. Thank you guys so much. We'll see you same time, same place next week.